before this game is over, we're bound to have some heavy rains, possibly an inch or more accumulation. What's more, there's a strong southeasterly wind blowing about 20 miles an hour. Would you prefer to go bear hunting with a switch or play defense against Florida? Auburn doesn't have an option tonight. Otherwise, they'd be headed to the woods by now. The Tigers will try to do something that no other team has been able to do, contain the Gators' high-scoring offense. Welcome to Jordan-Hare Stadium in Auburn. Hello again, everybody, in War Eagle with Stan White and Quentin Riggins. I'm Jim Fife. Florida is ranked first in one national poll, second in another. How good are the Gators? Maybe the best ever. Their quarterback has 20 touchdown passes compared to Auburn's 3. The Gators' average margin of victory, 40 points. 2 receivers have over 100 career catches. Small wonder they're ranked so high. But this edition of the Gators has another ingredient that we haven't seen much of before. A good defense that features one of college football's best pass rushers and a great secondary that includes an All-American cornerback. How in the world can Auburn compete with this team? We're about to find out if the Tigers can. Hood at the 5 on the near side. Carter at the 4 on the far side. There's the boot. It's high, end over end. It'll be fielded back there by Carter at the goal line. Straight up between the hash marks. Cuts to the outside of the 15. Got some running in the 25. He's at the 30. 35 down this near sideline. 40. 45, 50. He's at the 45, the 40. And he's hit and dropped from behind inside the 35-yard line. Tim Carter with a brilliant kickoff return.
Every time this guy touches the ball and kickoff returns, it's just almost. And this time he got through the hole and turned on that speed and went down the right sideline before going down on the 32-yard line of Florida. That's what Auburn needed out of his special teams.
68-yard return before Johnny Lamar stopped him from behind. Carter tight rope the sidelines after he cut to this near side boundary. And he was on his way. Lamar is all that saved the day for the Gators. Here's a 45-yard attempt by Damon Duvall. Justin Fetzko kneels at the 35. Slide angle back to the left for the right-footed kicker. The snap, spot, kick away. He's got distance. It is good. We are tied at Jordan-Hare Stadium as Auburn answers the Florida field goal. Grossman under center this time, takes a short drop, pump fakes, he's in trouble. He lost the football, he goes down. He maintains possession back at the 46-yard line. He dropped the ball and fell on it. Rashad Walker fell on him.
That was a good job down here by Carlos Rogers on the left side. Rex Grossman took a quick three-step drop and wanted a hitch route. Didn't come open, but Rashad Walker comes from the outside on the blitz. James Collier comes on the inside, and Gillespie had to make up his mind on who to take, and Rashad Walker gets to Rex Grossman.
Big challenge here for the Auburn defense. Grossman pulls away from center, sets up with time, throwing in the end zone, intercepted! Intercepted by Roderick Hood. Roderick Hood with the Auburn interception, cut in front of Jabbar Gaffney.
What a play.
Big, big play.
What a play by number 36, Roderick Hood. He turned into the receiver on that play. That is the note of a good defensive back. He gets his eyes and his head up, and he puts it on the ball, and he just pushes the wide receiver, does an excellent job of playing the ball. That was what Auburn needed, is a big play on defense, and they got it from Roderick Hood.
Hear the crowd cheering them on. Twin receivers left. Daniel Cobb has the ball. Deep snap in the shotgun. Cobb's going to throw downfield. Cassinius Moore, he's got it, a diving catch at the 30, and he falls down at the 28-yard line. Terrific. Cobb to Moore. Mike Nateel had the coverage. That's good for 31 yards and a first down.
What a throwing catch right there by Daniel Cobb. And Cassinius Moore lays his body out, stretches out horizontal. Daniel Cobb looks off to the left. He lobs it over the linebacker. What a throw right there. 31 yards. Auburn's in business.
2:17 to play in the first quarter. The Tigers at the Gator 28. Crowd likes the decision. Marcel Willis split to the left. Two receivers to the short side, the right. Fourth down and 3 at the 21. Jarris McIntyre goes in motion right to left. Cobb has it in the shotgun. Looking with time over the middle. Pass caught. First down, I believe. Caught by D.D. Green. He fumbled the ball after he was tackled at the 18-yard line, but the ground caused that fumble, apparently. And Auburn should have possession and a first down, but let's wait and see. If they rule it that he was had fumbled the ball before he hit the ground, it'll be Florida ball because the Gators picked it up.
But first, initially, the referee came in and said he was down. He was down. The ball came out after he had went down. But now they're talking about it.
Looking at the replay screen, I believe they've awarded Auburn the ball because they're measuring for the first down. Otherwise, they wouldn't be measuring. Wouldn't be any reason to. First down, Auburn, by half the length of the ball. Another heart-stopping play. Both ends are split. Cobb's going to hand it off to Moore. Cuts to the left. Moore is at the five. They stand him up. He keeps on driving and pulls the tacklers with him into the one-yard line. Alex Brown had hold of him, as did a couple of other Gators. They stood him up back around the five, but he just would not stop. Lito Shepard came up from the secondary, and finally they got him off his feet at the one-yard line, second and goal.
Well, Kendall Simmons, right, they're going right behind him, the All-American candidate. Good cut by Cassinius Moore, cutting it outside and just taking Lito Shepard with him and introducing himself in a big way.
Fourth down and goal from inside the one. Same formation. They're in the eye. Cobb calling the play. He has it. He drives on the quarterback sneak. He's in. Touchdown, Auburn! Daniel Cobb from about a half a yard out. He put his 230 pounds behind that. And he's finally able to punch it in. There is a flag on the play. Flag came after the play, apparently. And let's see if the touchdown stands. It's on the board.
That play right there, Ronnie Brown did a good job. It looked as if he was going to be initially stopped. Ronnie Brown put his 230-pound frame behind Daniel Cobb and pushed the and surged him
touchdown
into the end zone.
After the play, personal foul on the defense. That penalty will be half the distance to the goal on the try for point.
Third and just over a yard. Both ends are split for Grossman. Quick snap. Grossman the pitch to the tailback Gillespie. Gillespie is hit behind the line, did not make it. Mayo Sowell got him. Sowell hit him first. Alton Moore got him afterwards. And that cost the Gators about a yard loss.
Well, it really did. This Auburn defense is really playing some just inspired football. Listen to them, and the crowd's letting them know how much they appreciate it.
Here comes the crowd noise. Rising in support of Auburn's defense. Single setback. Grossman from under center. Has him in the blitz, and he throws, and this one may have been intercepted. Let's see. It may have been intercepted, Auburn. It was Philip Pate, who's having a career game in his Auburn debut tonight. He fielded that right at his shoe tops at the 29-yard line.
That was a really good job. He just took the place of Dontarius Thomas, who came off limping. Philip Pate seeing considerable action tonight. You saw the crowd noise right there, my friends, get to that Florida offense. He threw that off his back foot before Gillespie was able to make a cut. Philip Pate right there, the sophomore from Birmingham, Alabama, to pull it in.
Daniel Cobb is a quarterback. He's got two wide receivers to his left and one to the right side. He's in the shotgun. Single setback. Cobb's going to hand it off. No, he's going to keep. He's across the 20, 25, 30. Cobb's still on his feet to the 35, to the 40. And down he goes at the 41-yard line. A beautiful fake by Cobb. And Cobb sprinted off the left side. And he's got about 21 yards and a first down. Florida just reloading virtually the entire offense.
Florida,
they're
going to
send a punter in. Florida on third and 25 indicates they'll punt. They've got their whole punting unit in there. Never thought I'd see the day. Auburn's not buying it, though. They don't have anybody back in safety. Leach drops the ball. Leach is in trouble. Hunter trying to pull away, but they'll hit him back at the 26-yard line. Loose football. They try to lateral it, but now they get him deeper inside the 20.
It's fourth down now, though. If that was third down, that was third down. Now it's fourth down.
They hit the punter. He tried to lateral. And that cost him another 4 or 5 yards, and Florida comes up with a loose ball. But it's our play. Leach couldn't get the handle. They pulled him down way back there, but he tried to lateral. Well, actually, the loose ball, a fumble, was picked up, and then they tried to lateral and did, and got it down to the 19-yard line. On the field is Matt Leach. Now Auburn would hope for another fumble here. Leach waits at the 6. He'll kick to Hood and single safety back around the Auburn 39. Long count. Fourth and 11. It rolled back to him. He picks it up around the 2 or 3. And Auburn's on it, I believe, about the 4-yard line. Auburn will have the ball at the Florida 3 or 4-yard line. What a turn of events, Stan.
That ball just bounced back there. It didn't even give the punter a chance to get it, and it was at his feet. And what a turn. Like you said, the special teams playing a big role tonight.
It rolled back there like a ground ball to the shortstop. Rob Roberts is the snapper. Derek Graves got down there and fell on the ball, or fell on the punter as he was trying to get a hold of the football. But whatever the situation, Auburn's got 3 yards to take the lead. Third down, and I'm going to say a yard and three quarters. The tail end of the ball is resting at the two. And here comes the Tigers offense. Daniel Cobb leads them out there. Chris Butler will be in there with Michael Owen. So virtually a new backfield for Auburn. And they'll go with two tight ends and a wing back to the right side. From the 1.5, they need the better part of 2 yards. Motion by Jay Ratliff off the right wing. Now here's Cobb, going to give it off. Butler breaks one tackle behind the line. Butler slashes off the right side. He's in! Touchdown, Auburn! Butler was hit behind the line, shook off a tackle, and sprinted to the right, and scores the go-ahead points as Auburn is up 16-13.
What a play call right there. A whole new backfield with Chris Butler, Michael Owens. They hand it off behind Jay Ratliff coming in motion. He cuts to the outside and takes it in for a touchdown.
And Auburn is up 17-13 on top-ranked Florida. One play into the fourth quarter. We're a long way from home, folks. They break up the eye in the backfield behind Grossman. Grossman is going to play fake and set up and throw. Ball is tipped. It is intercepted. Intercepted, Auburn to the 25 and spilled at the 23-yard line. Mayo foul. It was tipped at the line of scrimmage by Rob Roberts, the fullback, right into the hands of foul, and Auburn's in business again.
Well, it was another big defensive play by that inspired Auburn defense. Mayo Sowell playing a lot tonight because of the injury to Pounds and Brown. Comes up after the tip with a huge turnover for Auburn. They're in business on Florida's 22.
Duval will kick from the 23. It's going to be a 33-yard effort. Petsko, the holder. The ball will be teed up over on the far side hash mark. So the angle, sharp angle, back to the right. The snap, the spot, kick is away. He drilled it. It is good. Damon Duval, with room to spare, splits the uprights. And Auburn enjoys a 20-13 lead. Florida showing blitz. Cobb has the snap. He's looking. Has some time. Will he run? No, he'll throw it upfield. Wide open receiver. 25, 30. It's Diamond to the 35, and Diamond is butted down at the 39-yard line. Again, a single setback in the shotgun. Cobb looking downfield. Cobb looking, going to throw the fade route down there to Moore. He's got it! A great catch inside the 30, and he falls forward to the 26-yard line. Second time tonight he's thrown to Ksenius Moore, and Moore's come up with a great catch. Todd Johnson had the coverage for Florida.
Good play right there, Daniel Cobb, to Ksenius Moore. He does a wheel route. He goes into the flat, and he turns it up right there and just turns his speed on. Not the fastest back we have, but he is showing what kind of concentration and what kind of hands he's got tonight.
From the shotgun, Daniel Cobb waiting for the snap. Just in the nick of time, he has it. He looks downfield. He throws. Pass is caught inside the 10. First down to the 8-yard line. Carnell Williams. Daniel Cobb showing great moxie. Wonderful poise in that pocket. Florida had the good rush on, but he stood in there, and he threw the pass to Carnell Williams, coming from the left to the right side of the field, and Auburn is first and goal at the Gator 7.
How about these young players for Auburn stepping up at a big time right there? The true freshman from Etowah. Carnell Williams coming up with a big grab. Daniel Cobb, nice throw.
Cobb sends Williams out on the right flank. Waits and gets it. Looks with time. Cobb is going to run, drop the football, rolls into the end zone, and the Florida Gators fall on it. He fumbled it forward, and Florida fell on the ball for a touchback. Oh, my goodness. It was Todd Johnson who got it. It just squirted out of his hands. I don't know if that was because of the rain or what the situation, but he lost control of it. He fumbled it forward from about the 5-yard line. It rolled into the end zone, and 2 yards in there, Johnson was there to fall on it. Nobody around for Auburn.
He got swiped behind him by a defensive player, maybe an Alex Brown. I think he got, Alex Brown may have got his hand on it when he started, right? Yes, Alex Brown got his hand on it, and Daniel Cobb tried to scoop it up and just couldn't do it. Oh, man, what a turnover.
4:45 to play. Grossman has it on the right hash mark. On a delay up the middle, he's going to fake and roll to his right. Grossman's going to load it up and go way downfield. Intercepted at the 5-yard line. Out to the 15, to the 20, and on to the 23, Carlos Dansby. He faked the inside handoff.
Intercepted by number 11.
Sprinted out to the right, threw it in a desperation heave downfield. Dansby was just waiting for that one like a man waiting for a punt return.
Oh, he certainly was. The ball looked like it slipped on Rex Grossman when he let it go. He didn't get anything on it. A very poor decision right there. His left foot slipped, I think, on him on the wet turf, and a poor decision right there. And Spurrier, I'm sure, will talk to him about that, about just getting rid of it and coming back for the next play. Big play by Carlos Dansby.
Moore is going to roll out to the left and become the fourth wide receiver. Here's Cobb dumping it over the middle. Got an open hand, 30, 35, and out to the 39-yard line. Tight end Lorenzo Diamond. Cobb in the shotgun. He's got it. He's looking. Cobb out in the flat. It is caught. Sidestepping a tackler. That's Jarris McIntyre to the 50. He's to the 45, and he goes out of bounds, and Auburn's got a first down. First and 10 at the Gator 47. Single setback. Cobb from under center. Going to hand off to Williams. Williams cuts to the outside. He's to the line of scrimmage. Breaks the tackle at the 40 and keeps his feet and gets a first down to the 35-yard line. What an incredible run by Carnell Williams. Todd Johnson had to tackle him way downfield. A 10-yard sprint. Not quite enough for the first down, I think. They're going to put knee on the ground just outside the 35.
How about the true freshman from Etowah, Alabama, coming up big on a 9-yard gain, cuts back to the weak side and just turns on with his quick feet and gets 9 yards.
Second and 12. The ball at the Gator 32, 38 seconds to go. Cobb's going to hand it off to Williams. Williams up the middle, breaking tackles, and he pulls his way into the 26-yard line. This is 44 yards straight ahead. Fetzko, the holder. This could be your ball game right here. Waiting for the snap is Fetzko. Duvall kicks it away. High, long. It is good! It's good! And Auburn's got the lead with 10 seconds to go. A 44-yarder by Damon Duvall.
Jim, it never had a doubt. It split the middles. It could have been 4 yards wide, and it would have went through. It never showed any doubt as the rain is falling at Jordan-Hare Stadium tonight, 23-20 with 10 seconds to go.
And the wind has whipped up again, too. 10 seconds left. It's 23-20 Auburn. Damon Duvall has given the Tigers the lead in the closing seconds, but don't forget, Florida tied this thing at 20 on a long pass play, one snap after Auburn had taken a 20-13 lead.
They really did. It only took them about 6 seconds. But now Auburn is going to play prevent defense. First of all, they've got to get this kickoff tackle, a tackle. But they've got to play prevent, keep them in front of them. And I remember about 8 years ago, a certain number 43 hit a 43-yarder to win the game against Florida, Scott Edwards.
3 weeks in a row, Duvall has given Auburn the lead late in the game. Two of them resulted in victories.
Yeah, they could run a hook and ladder right here.
Well, they'll do something fancy, I guarantee you that. Grossman, one shot in his gun. Out of the shotgun on a penalty play. Grossman sprints, dodging tackles. Rolls to the right. Grossman going to run. He'll set up. He'll try to throw. He's going to run. Time is out on the clock. They hit him from behind. Ball is loose. Picked up by a Florida lineman. There is a penalty marker down, and he is knocked off his feet. Out at the 28-29-yard line. Let's see who the penalty was against. It must have been against Florida, I'm assuming, because illegal procedure, illegal formation. There's that call again against the Gators. This game is over. Ladies and gentlemen, the Auburn Tigers have done the impossible. They have absolutely shocked the football world. A 21-point underdog to the number one ranked team in America. The Auburn Tigers have defeated the Florida Gators 23-20 at Jordan-Hare Stadium. Yes, I do believe in miracles.
I tell you what, the Auburn faithful are storming the field. It is pandemonium down here at Jordan-Hare Stadium. It's just an amazing sight. I'm speechless.
I am totally speechless. I am numb. I just can't believe what I've seen. Stan White, we have seen history made in this wonderful stadium tonight. Auburn 23, Florida 20. Can you believe what we have seen?
It is amazing. It is amazing. We're going to savor it all into the night. The faithful keep on coming onto the field. I think they may be going for the goalpost. A 21-point underdog. I think we cracked the top 25 now. What do you think, Jim Pipe?
I don't think they can keep them out now. I'll tell you what else. The cops can't keep the fans off the field. This is a mob scene out here. That goalpost is coming down, like it or not. They are pouring out onto the field. And whatever the policemen are trying to do to stop it is for naught.
It is not going to happen. They are celebrating, and it will last all night, all tomorrow. It is just amazing.
Get out to toilet paper, because Toomer's Corner is going to be buried tonight.
We will be going up there, and we're right in the middle of them. It is amazing. Damon Duvall, 3 weeks in a row. Game-winning field goal, never had a doubt, and they're taking the goalpost down that he put it through.
A 44-yarder.
Man.
I can forgive any demonstration like we're seeing, because it's a celebration. No harm intended. These kids are having the time of their life. They have seen something that nobody thought that they would ever see.
One of the biggest upsets of this college football season. What would you do without Damon Duvall? 3 weeks in a row.
I don't know. I tell you, the whole football team, offensively, we didn't play great. Damon made it when we needed it. Defense played super. I'm proud for the entire group. What a great win.
Coach, congratulations, Damon, for the third week in a row. This is becoming a lot.
It feels great, but, you know, our defense played the whole game. I give the credit to this and the defense. You know, Florida's got great offense. Defense came out, knew what they had to do, and pulled it through for us. I just had an easy job.
I saw you retire your suit 3 times in 2 minutes. I know you had to try to hook it in. Yeah. How does it feel?
Feels great, man. You know, coming out, doing my job, and, you know, it's a great feeling being number one team in the nation.
Congratulations to you both. Enjoy the win.
Guys, y'all just put on one great effort. That was a team effort. That wasn't individual. Not one person in here did any more than the other. We needed a crowd in the stands. You played with your heart and your soul, and the good Lord gave you an opportunity to get it done. Everybody feel this feeling right now, guys, because it doesn't happen very often. It doesn't happen very often when you have an opportunity to take the number one team on and you whip them. This is for all the guys in here that are seniors. Last four ball games, we've won in the fourth quarter. All the way down to the end.
We had faith in ourselves. We just did what Coach Witt told us to. You know, he had faith in us to put us in there, and we had to go with what we had. So God bless us with a victory. We played hard.
Last week when I saw a couple linebackers go down against Mississippi State, I knew I had to step up and play this week. And they really weren't sure if I was 100% healthy, but I had to go because we had no one else.
We just came in the game plan, you know, knowing that if we hung around with them, you know, that we was going to keep getting stronger and stronger. We had to limit the big plays, and we know if we limit that big plays, that it would keep us in the game longer. I mean, we just thrived off playing good team ball and having faith. So nobody picked us to be here at the beginning of the year, and nobody picked us to beat them. So all we had was just, you know, this Auburn team and, you know, the fans and this university behind us.
First of all praise be to God. Second of all, you know, we work. We really, really work. But I tell you, we got a great coaching staff. You know, they're putting us in a position to get these kind of wins. They bust our butts in practice. They bust our butts in practice, man, and that's what it's all about. That's what it's like. It's, there's no one person there. It's all a family. People are going to notice that eventually. I don't know what we got to do, but they're going to notice that eventually. This is a family, and the Lord's leading us on.
I knew all of us could compete with them all week, man. We just had to believe in it, and we did that, and, you know, we gave up some plays. I mean, me personally, I gave up a touchdown, but we just had faith in each other, and we kept pushing.
Yo, Coach Mazzoni, he came to me and said, you know, spend a little extra time this week. If we're not moving the ball, we might, you know, probably might give you a chance. And sure enough, it ended up like that. And I got my chance. I took advantage of it, and we pulled out a win.